Back in 1948, Australia's first Holden started a motoring revolution in this country. Almost 40 years later, this Holden derivative promises to start a full-scale war. It's the HDT Director, reflecting, as the publicists point out, the inspiration and soul of Peter Brock.
I have a motor car which you can probably see circulating behind me, which is capable of gaining us some much-earned export dollars, and Holdens are trying to stop me, and I'm a pretty determined sort of person, and I'm pressing on. They said to me, if you, Peter Brock, announce this car at the end of this week, we'll withdraw all support for you. Well, I've gone ahead and I've announced it.
Brock and Holden's Motor Company have been down a few rough roads together since they formed an association 19 years ago. The long-haired kid from Eltham in Victoria has been synonymous with the General's products in touring car competition since 1969. He's won the Bathurst Hardy Classic 8 times in an assortment of 6 and 8 cylinder General Motors equipment, and has always been seen as the white knight by the company's marketing department.
The real issue is, I'm an Australian, I've got some cars here I manufacture, they are fantastic motor cars, I'm proud of them, and we can export them.
When Peter Brock and John Harvey formed Holden Dealer Team Special Vehicles 7 years ago, it was a winner from day one. A special GM dealer network processed orders for the Brock modified cars. The vehicles came straight from the assembly line to HDT headquarters in Port Melbourne, where they were given the Brock treatment and then delivered to the dealers. The sceptics, though, claim Peter Perfect was just a frontman for the General. His HDT operation as autonomous as the Pope to the Vatican.
I can tell you that's just not so. Certainly, we have to get along with each other. I'm good for General Motors are good for me, and as long as we look at it that way, that's fine. But I can absolutely assure you that GM might back me with a bit of kind and might pat me on the back occasionally and say, well, keep at it, you know, what you're doing is good stuff, and we agree with it, but we have arguments. Sometimes they want to do something one way, I want to do it another, and the backing I have might be support and kind, but certainly not financial.
The marriage between Brock and General Motors began to hit a stormy patch or two when the Aussie sports hero and his friend Eric Dowker released this little gadget, the DB Energy Polariser. The device is supposed to cure many ills in the normal road car. Let's face it, for $480, it should do something. Holden's Motor Company put it another way. They said the polariser had no technical merit. Undeterred, Brock and Dowker pressed ahead with the release of their new prototype car, the GM-based Brock Director, and against the wishes of Holden. HMC claim it wanted more time to test and evaluate the car before going public. At 5:30 on Friday afternoon, February 20th, Holden's Motor Company terminated its business relationship with Peter Brock and the HDT. A few days ago, John Harvey and Alan Moffat followed suit.
I suppose from the sports point of view, will be odd to see him not on the grid for sure, but Peter's in control of his own destiny, and he's chosen this particular way, and I find it rather odd, but that's his business, and I wish him well in his future.
I think it'll be fairly difficult for Peter to get the whole act together again. It's obviously going to be extremely hard to motivate the boys now that half the team have seemed to have gone their own way. But Peter's a very, very strong-willed character, and I'm sure he'll get it all together.
I've never seen such a large deck of cards come down so quickly. It's a shame, really, from the credibility of a lot of us that are in the sport. And I'm sure there's a lot of people that will be amazed the way it's all happened, but it has, and we've all been instrumental in our own undoings from time to time, and I guess he's got to look at himself, but I hope that he does the rest of the championship and stays in motorsport.
1987 started so well for Peter Brock and the Mobil Holden dealer team. Their two Commodores beat the field into submission to take the Wellington 500 street race for the second successive year. Brock crossing the line just ahead of teammate John Harvey. The future at the moment, though, looks bleak. Whether the rift between Holden's Motor Company and HDT can be healed is a question only Brock himself knows. Just how much he cares is the real issue.
Now the face that I see in my mirror, more and more, is a stranger to me. more and more I can see there's a danger in becoming what I never thought I'd be. Some days a diamond, some days a stone, sometimes